Will sin and death ever end? Yes. Romans 6:6 teaches us that sin is going to be destroyed, and we are promised in 1 Corinthians that the last enemy to be destroyed is death. When we pass a building under construction, do we criticize the builder? Do we say, "This looks terrible. The walls aren't completed, and I see bricks and materials everywhere on the ground. It's not a solid structure, and it will never be finished." Of course we don't say this because we know the building is in progress. It takes time and care for the builder to finish the project so we can eventually appreciate its quality and beauty. It may seem like a long time, but finally the day comes when what first looked like a messy, unfinished construction site has become a magnificent skyscraper. This is how it is with God's plan. Some may say that it appears God has forgotten about humankind, but that's because His plan is still in progress. Our narrow, imperfect viewpoint is short-sighted, so we can only see a tiny bit of what's around us. God looks at things from a bigger, long-term, eternal perspective. His plan might not appear to be happening as fast as people may want or expect it to be. The Bible assures us that Satan will be destroyed as well as sin and death. Since the Bible is the inspired Word of God, we can put our full trust in it. Revelation says, "He will wipe every tear from their eyes, and there will be no more death, or sorrow, or crying, or pain. All these things are gone forever." In God's kingdom, after people are resurrected on a perfect earth, they'll be given lots of help to learn how to live righteously. People will apologize for hurting others, and, in turn, they will forgive those who hurt them. God permits evil and sin for a limited time, but it's for a wise purpose, to teach an everlasting lesson for all of us, that sin only brings sorrow and death, but obedience to God and His righteous principles brings life and happiness. So, will sin and death ever end? The Bible tells us the answer is yes, but we must be patient, because like our example of the unfinished building, God's plan isn't finished yet either. Thanks for liking and subscribing.